Good morning. Hi, this is Santosh Dogra here. I am here to present you housing pricing prediction presentation. This is my term 2 project on machine learning, where we have analyzed the data on housing prices and what are the factors which affects the pricing. We have discussed on that, and as well as we have developed a model, which model will be accurate. So I will start my presentation right now. Housing is one of the most essential and most basic need of any human being. Being a social animal, he lives in the concrete jungle, not in the forest. So he keeps on looking out for the home. The children grows up, the father, they keep on looking out for home to reside. So housing plays a very crucial factor. They have to keep on changing the cities. So there are buyers, there are sellers. So we will predict the pricing. What are different factors one look at to when they decide on buying the price, by buying the house? So house value is simply not just more on the just location, the pricing factor. It is more related to the emotions as well as of certain categorical features also, where it is located, how far is from my workplace, how far is from school, how far is what are the different facilities available. So educated person looks into the all the data and they decide, as well as seller, the buy sellers, they decide on these things and they sell it to the buyer. We have uploaded the data and we have tried out to figure out what are the different columns which is there, how many data sets is available. We have analyzed at 1460 observation, it had and 81 columns. In 81 column, it included area of the house, how old is the house, location of the house, where it is located, how much it is far from the market, what are the transport available, transportability is there, whether how many floor the house is having, whether it's a ground plus one or it's just ground, how was the exterior, how was the utilities, play area and other factors, garage, etc. So these are the things which affect on the decision on buying the house. So we had described the data, we have found out the data and we did the analysis. And how did we have to do exploration. We have what are to understand before we develop a model. We should know what affects the target price. Target price is the sales price. What are different things which is affecting, how whether it's affecting the unilaterally or there are two factors which combinedly affect, or it is affects the multiple factors. So we have analyzed the data on the various aspect, univariate analysis, bivariate analysis, multivariate analysis, and the cost table. We used a histogram, bar plot, and etc. to find out the different factors, and we cleaned the data also. So we start the data analysis part. We started the data analysis, and we just before we start up, before we do anything, we found out what are the normal distribution, what are the skewness and cuttosis. We found out that normal distribution is right a little bit skewed. So the mean was $1,89,21, which was very expensive. So that's the data which is currently we are having. Then we analyzed the data on the various factors. On the 81 column it was not possible, so we took the only top 10 factors which is affecting the sales price. So overall quality, ground living area, garage area, total basement square feet, first floor, etc. So these are the cost correlated factor which is directly correlated to the sales price. So we tried to do multivariable analysis of the sale price on the pair by the pair plotting on the top criteria like overall quality score. Coral quality score, the ground living area, garage car, how size of the garage car is there, the grade levels and etc. We tried to correlate to them. So that analysis we did. Then we analyzed the bivariate analysis of the sale price versus overall quality. So the data clearly indicated the higher the quality score, higher the price. So it's directly correlated. And we analyze the data also with the sales price with the living area. So living area again is highly correlated, 10 more concentrated on the middle segment. There were the again there were outliers. Some of the outliers were depicting this value deals, and some of the outliers had high premium deals. Did this this was analysis, and we categorically there are different categories apart from the emotional with apart from the numerical data. There was a categorical data which is also available in the data set. We have extracted and separated them. So neighborhood, typical neighborhood, who are in the neighborhood. This also decide the pricing factor, the exterior quality, wall quality, kitchen quality, foundation. So these are the top factors which are affecting the categorical factors which are affecting the price. So categorical feature analysis, which takes into consideration sale price versus sales correlations with the sales price and sales conditions. Sales conditions has a high correlation. So then we try to do the histogram analysis on the numerical variable, on a numerical variable we did the histogram. So we did with all the analysis with them, more than 41 analysis we did, and mostly data mostly were with the rightly skewed. After completion of the numerical variables, we started on the categorical variable analysis. In categorical analysis, we did around more than 60 analysis. So in the box varieties performed the categorical analysis, and most variables had been dealing with the outliers. So definitely, so that's that factor can be considered. That factor which can be developed by the model, which is a decision theory. So we will do. I will just stick which are the rest of the 40 analysis which I had done. So on the different parameters, on the variable factor, variable heating, etc., paint qualities, exterior quality, foundation. In the previous data, we had seen the analysis on the civil construction, building type. So lots of data on the bar plot analysis is done, and you can see. And the analysis it is dealing with the exterior outliers also. So before to do the data pre-processing, before we develop the model, we'd like to fix the missing values. We found out that pool has the maximum missing value than the miscellaneous feature LA. So we identified them and fixed them. So once we fix the data with the missing values, the price distribution had come down to a very normal distribution, and the skewness was brought under control, so it was ready for the analysis. So model training, evaluation, and the prediction. So we will go through one by one. There are models which are there: linear regression models, and the random forest. So we will start by linear regression. In linear regression, with the test conducted, living area and the sale price, we did. We conducted a run test with the 5 testers conducted with the 5-7 second, and we found it okay. We also conducted the test on a test. So 6 tests were conducted in 2 seconds, and it resulted found to be okay. So result where sale prices was a living area, because of the linear regression we can consider only one factor, and other factors remain constant. So this is the how the value had come. So I will share you the animated forum right now, animated one. So this is how it looks like. Okay, this is how it looks like. So this is living area by animation format of the my linear regression. So sale price is linear regression. It is how it is keeps on moving, and the distribution is coming up. Okay, and I'll show you my Jupyter notebook later on. Then we did a decision tree regression. We test conditional train data, but R square score low was very low. So result where we had put out in the CSV format and submitted it. So, but results were not encouraging. Then afterwards, we did a random forest regression analysis. Tests are conducted on a train data as well as test data. Results were encouraging, and height has a high R square score of approximately 98%, 0.989769. So result, I have shown you the result plotted here. So you can see that it's a query leaf correctly plotted, as well as again that distribution is correctly there. Then we need to conducted the test. The test, the blue line and the red line, that and blue line with the test, and you can see the blue line up is a perfect prediction. So that was the end of the power model building exercise. So the time is right now is to conclude. The conclusion is that data science is about discovering the hidden patterns in data. We need to find out what is there. We need to understand the target. We need to understand the variables. So data is important to discover patterns in data. Without examining the data, our pattern detection will be imperfect. So without pattern detection, we cannot draw the conclusion about the identity data. Therefore, both ideas are needed to drawing conclusions. So we need to analyze the data deeply so that we can predict the model correctly. So there are three factors which is directly influencing on the machine learning programming. So we need to understand the variables, what is the problem about, what are the target variables, what do you variables represent, how to affect, what are different directly correlated, which out of the direct indirectly correlated. So variable analysis we need to do afterwards. So focus on the target variable predicted and try to clean up as soon as possible way so that we come through this decision tree, we can know how can we reach to the all the solution. So once you have reached to the all the answers on the end of the problem, then you can build and test the patterns detected through algorithm. So with the help of just random helpers classifier, we came to know that this is one of the best analysis for the housing pricing prediction. So is it possible to predict the house price very fairly good? So if you are going to buy a house, so you can contact me. I can definitely help you. So these are the certain references which I have done and taken the help of. So before I thank you, let me show you my Jupyter notebook. Here. So housing pricing prediction, this is my Jupyter notebook. So we had house introduction, the problem statement, understanding client and their problem, data descriptions, data description. We had done the strategy, area of the house, of the description of the, all the columns, description of the, all the columns is there, whatever is there. And we imported all the packages which is there. So we had to, I put down all the things in single shot. Then we import the data set, find out how the data exploration, data analysis, housing data, information, what are the differences there, missing data, finding out. So lots of other things which is there and which I have shown you in the my PPT also. So something which is not there also, but we have to find out. We have PPT, everything cannot be there. So this is the distribution which we have shown you in the PPT. This is also so multiple variable analysis. This is the correlations which you cannot see all the 81. So we have shown only the top 10. Going down. So this is also I have plotted it up. This is the missing value. This is histogram on numerical. Now next will be the bar plotting for the categorical. This is how all the more than 60 analysis which is been done. So data pre-processing, cleaning of the data, missing value, and we clean the data. afterwards. Then future translation or future engineering, so to clean the data. So predicting this is just an understanding of the linear regression, simple linear regressions. So so that just to make you understand on the PPT side, this is a test, okay. This is the train after the test, okay. Multivariable regression analysis, which you saw right now, multivariable regression analysis, decision tree model, data processing. So this is the submission for the regression analysis, which I will attach in analysis, the random forest regression. We have done only for correlation factors, which where the 0.5 was there. So we didn't want it to do for all the factor. So we take only 7, 8, and we did the training as well as the testing data. And this is how my random forest result look like, and this is how my train and test did it. So this is the conclusion also which I have done. So this was the Jupyter notebook from my side. So that's all from my side. I thank for increasing my knowledge as well as giving me the lots of exposure. So thank you. Bye-bye.